Welcome to another episode of the Ask Aviarya show. We're going to get in right to the Gita section. So here's what we heard today. This person who goes to his Guruji and he says, Guruji, tell me, what do you need to become successful in life? Luck, fate, God, effort, what do I need? And before you answer, you know what? I've been a spiritual person for a very long time. I've been on this path for a very long time. I think I've more or less understood the answer, but I've just come here for a reconfirmation. So the Guru asked him, what have you understood so far? He said, what I think is that God, luck, fate and effort, I have to have the right priorities, right balance, right mix of everything. And that's what's going to make my life perfect and I'm going to become successful, right? And the Guru said, you know what? Let me give you a different answer. And what he said was amazing. He said, God, you don't know. Luck is not in your control. Fate is called fate because you don't know how it's going to roll out. The only thing that you have in your hands, only thing that you have control over, is effort. One more thing I'll add to that is concentrated effort. Instead of doing effort in 10 different directions, if you're doing effort in one direction, you will definitely get those results. When I heard that, I thought I have to share it on the Ask Aviarya show. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. We're in the 7 puppies section. We're always talking about dogs, and all you dog lovers out there, thank you so much for loving this section and commenting on this section. Last week, I promised my daughter that I am going to buy her another dog. Yes, we've got 7 dogs. She wanted another puppy. They really take care of the pups that we have at home. And she did deserve another one, we thought. So we'll make it 8. As soon as I put that on Facebook, that I am going to buy my daughter another dog, if you have a recommendation, if somebody's selling a nice litter from... And the barrage of comments that I got, do not buy, adopt, rescue. And that set me thinking. And I went back to my daughter and we had a chat. She's 10 years old, grown up enough to have a long conversation with me and to know exactly what she wants and her likes and dislikes. And when we together tried to understand that there are so many beautiful puppies out there that need to be rescued. There are so many of them that need to be adopted. We decided that we're going to adopt a new puppy now. Now, through this show, I'm asking you, we've had dogs of all kinds, all breeds. Through this show, I'm asking you, for my 10-year-old daughter, I'm looking to get another puppy. Which kind of puppy should we adopt? Please leave your comments in the comment section below. We'd love to hear from you. It's time for questions, and I believe we again have video questions today. So let's bring them on.
Hi. My question for today relates to working with brands. More often than not, a lot of brands have very strict brand guidelines that they wish to adhere to. In such cases, when working on their social media strategy, for example, how does one approach being creative when there are certain guidelines that one's bound by? And if the answer to this is client-specific, then what should be the right questions that we as digital consultants should ask them in order to understand where the line is in between being creative and still being brand specific? Thank you.
You lighting a cigarette on the show?
Why? Because nicotine kills? Smoking kills? Do you know the largest cause of death is diabetes and not smoking? And yet you wouldn't have had this reaction if I had pulled out a Snickers bar. There is a mafia which does not want nicotine farming to happen. Otherwise, diabetes is definitely the largest killer in this world and not nicotine. This argument, though I just made it up, when I presented this argument to a few friends of mine, 3 out of those 5 believed and 2 started smoking. The point I'm trying to make is that as digital marketers, as brand evangelists, we create perceptions. I do not want to create a perception for smoking, but I wanted to make a point that as marketers, we create perceptions. Perceptions create demand. Demand ensures that products are bought and sold, and the consumer economy keeps moving. But we have a responsibility. We have to give the right message, and we have to say it in a particular way. As human beings, as digital marketers, our role is the same. We have to portray our brand message in a certain way. Be firm, be clear, be respectful. I was talking to my 6-year-old daughter the other day. I walked into the room after a long day at work, and I opened the door, and there she was, scribbling on the wall. And I said, hey, what are you doing? Stop that scribbling, are you stupid? Guess what she did? She kept on drawing. She didn't stop. I told her, don't be stupid and never do that again. I was angry. Few days later, I walked in again. I found her scribbling again. She looked at me and she started scribbling even more incessantly. I will not stop was the attitude look on her face. Because none of us want to be talked down to. Her ego was hurt. Hence, she wanted to keep doing what she was doing. So here's what I did. I said, you know what? I'm sure you're going to stop this and never do this again. Because you are a responsible girl now. You're growing up. And you're going to be 7 years old very soon. Guess what? That was the last day she's ever scribbled on any wall. Because she wanted to now live up to my expectation of being an adult, being a responsible child. So the way you portray a message to a fellow human being, it could be your client, it could be your daughter, depends on what kind of response it's going to have. Now, let's turn this whole story on its head and use it, employ it with our digital marketing, social media. Just by putting posts out there, we sometimes are talking down to the prospective audience. The reverse works brilliantly. Respect your audience. So if you're a hotelier and you're creating great banner ads and offers for your hotel guests to come into your new teppanyaki restaurant, you will talk to them about being stressed on the weekend and maybe come into your hotel to experience the spa. If they're hungry during lunch, your teppanyaki restaurant for the first time in the city does home deliveries or office deliveries. Reach out to them, understand what your client really wants, and make the messaging absolutely correct, respectful, courteous, relevant, current, and above all, keep it human, keep it humane. Once you do that, you start seeing the feeling that has been put into the campaign starts coming back. There are many Indian and American brands which have actually humanized digital marketing campaigns and got excellent results. Because like I said when I started, a brand, a person or a company or a corporation, once you're talking to another human being, you're portraying a message. The way you portray it will either piss off my ego completely or will make me feel that here is a friend who is giving me a message. And that, my friends, will be the winning and the losing, the victory or the vanquish of your brand. So if you're a digital marketer, a brand consultant, a marketing company or a brand yourself, take a step back and ask yourself, who am I speaking to and how am I speaking to them? Am I talking down to them or am I giving them the respect, the courtesy, keeping their message relevant, keeping their message current, keeping their message real? Am I doing that to my brand? Am I doing that for my brand? Am I doing that for my client? If you're doing that, if you're humanizing your messaging, you will definitely be winning social media 2016. Thank you for watching.
Hi, Avi. Hi, I'm Sakshi, an account manager, and I've been providing social media solutions to my clients since 2 years. Lately, I've started experiencing that whenever I'm running a contest on my clients' pages, even after investing money and after providing clearly the rules and regulations and the prize involved in that contest, people are not participating in my contest. Rather, they are just liking the post and they are not just participating in my contest. So can you suggest me some ways where I can actually urge people to participate in my contest rather than just liking the post?
Hi Sakshi, thank you for your question. If I've understood your question correctly, you're saying that you have been successfully running a lot of Facebook contests. And over the years, you've seen that the contests are getting a lot of likes, but not so much engagement, right? So I'll tell you what to do. See, a contest is a great idea. You feel, you know, the feeling of euphoria, the feeling of I may win is huge. Every human being has loved this idea. Even a word like free, F-R-E-E, resonates. You know, I've read and written a lot of articles on neuroscience and web design and internet marketing. So the study of neuroscience says that articles, that words like free, words like contest, I'm going to win something, you know, actually do something to the endorphins. We love it. But so do visuals. In most contests, I've seen that the end result, what am I going to get if I get part of the contest? Or who's, you know, how close am I to winning? Is it something which is going to be immediate? Or is it going to be a long time before this contest results are declared? If you can make it current, if you can make it real, saying the next 2 hours, engage with us, give us your feedback, and within the next 120 minutes, you will hear back from us if you won or not, or what you won. Number one, create an urgency, and I'm sure urgency works very well. Number two, keep the visuals of WIFFM in your mind all the time. What's in it for me? So a contest will work very well if you're able to convince your client, convince your prospective guest, convince your audience that this is what they're going to get: a flat screen TV, 2 nights stay at the hotel, a teppanyaki dinner for two, champagne, and 3 nights stay at a luxury resort, or whatever the contest is going to yield. Number three, has it happened in the past? I would love to see I would love to be proven the fact that 3 or 4 people have already won the contest in the past. So if you can amalgamate these three things into your contest, I am very sure that contest will 100% start working. Please share your comments after you implement these strategies in your Facebook marketing. Share your comments. We'd love to help you further. Thanks again for the question.
Question is that we have seen Google Hotel Finder listings becoming more prominent in Google search, and I think that this will only grow in the future. What I wanted to know was, do you think hotels are getting more conversions because of this? And if yes, what steps should we be taking so that our hotel gets the maximum profit from it? Another connected question about I have is about meta search engines like TripAdvisor that provide Trip Connect. Which do you think will give our hotel more conversions, Trip Connect or Google Ads?
Hi, thanks for your question. So what you're trying to ask is that your hotel has sort of dabbled with Hotel Finder on Google and run some ads there. And you've also contemplating working with TripAdvisor and Trip Connect, and which do you think is a better channel? For me to answer that question a little more in detail, especially for you, you need to tell me the type of hotel. Is it a budget hotel, guest house, resort, boutique, chain, whatever, which locality, I mean, in terms of which city, what demographics? That will help us sort of fine tune it way, way, way better. That's one point. But however, to help you with this question right here, Trip Connect works with your booking engine. So depending on which booking engine you're using, you can use Trip Connect and start running ads over there. And I have seen very good conversions happening on Trip Connect for most of the hotels. For Google Hotel Finder, we have personally not seen great results happening so far. Google Ads, however, is a different animal. Google Ads, especially banner ads, remarketed with smart remarketing. When I say smart remarketing, means that you're actually going after that customer. If that customer come to your hotel's page and gone to your spa page, and you know he's looking for a spa, so the next remarketing ad is about spa, and then a little bit subtly promoting the hotel and not just about the hotel. So in a way, you're carrying forward the communication. If that kind of remarketing with Google Hotel ads is what you want to start doing, it'll work wonders for you. Trip Connect will work very well for you. But in the end, I'd like to say one thing. There is no, and I said this in my first video, which I shot a few years back, and the fact still remains. you know, this is what I've told you from experience, without knowing what kind of hotel you are. But you know what? Take some budget out and experiment with both mediums. You never know what is in store for your particular hotel. The features in Google Hotel Finder and Trip Connect keep changing. It's a great idea to keep experimenting with both of them, and I'm sure you will do well. As long as your hotel marketing team and yourself have wear that hat which says, I am ready to experiment. I'm sure you'll do well. Thank you for your question. Thank you very much for watching the Ask Avi Arya show. I hope we were able to give you the right content, share with you the right examples, and give you the right answers to the question that you asked us on this show. We request you to subscribe, comment, and share this video. Thank you very much for watching.